Shall we start? Okay, ma'am. Good morning, one and all. It's my great pleasure to welcome all dear students to the valedictory session of virtual intercollegiate competitions to commemorate the World Environment Day 2022. And the theme of this World Environment Day is Only One Earth, which is organized by RBVRR Women's College and Government Degree College for Women, Begumpet. We are very happy to announce that 125 participants got registered in this virtual competition, out of which 126 students participated in quiz, 9 students presented e-posters, 11 students have given video presentations, and 5 students from Begumpet Women's College has prepared the models. Out of these, we have selected the 3 best presenters, and we will be awarding them with e-certificates. I congratulate all the prize winners on behalf of both the institutions. I would also like to thank Dr. Achita Devi, Madam Principal, RBVRR Women's College, Dr. K. Prabhavati, Madam Principal, Government Degree College for Women, Begumpet, and also my student and the HOD Chemistry of Begumpet Women's College, Dr. Pranita, and all the dear faculty coordinators, Srijana, Dr. Priyanka, Dr. Rafia Sultana, Mrs. M. Prabhavati, for making this event a grand success. And also I would like to congratulate and also thank all the students of various colleges like St. Anne's, Bhavan's, Koti Women's College, Usmania University, and the hosting institutions for registering for this particular competition, as well as winning the prizes. World Environment Day is the biggest international day for environment, which is led by UNEP, and it is held annually since 1973. It has grown to be the largest global platform for environmental protection. It is celebrated by millions of people across the world. This year, the theme is Only One Earth, which is the campaign slogan, with a focus on living sustainability in harmony with nature. Lastly, I would like to say, in the universe, we have billions of galaxies. In our galaxy, there are billions of planets, but there is only one Earth. Let's take care of it. So with this, I once again congratulate all the prize winners, and I request Srijana to continue the session. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I once again welcome all the participants for this intercollegiate competitions to commemorate World Environment Day, which was organized by Department of Chemistry, RBVRR Women's College and Government Degree College for Women. So now I request Pranita ma'am to take over the session, to speak few words about this competition.
Let's continue our student session, madam.
Okay,
ma'am. So, ma'am.
Yeah, you can announce.
First announcement. So now it's time to announce the winners who have enthusiastically participated in this intercollegiate competitions. So then first, in the category of video making, the first prize goes to G.S. Bhavana from Government Degree College for Women, Begumpet. She has presented a video presentation on stability with sustainability. I congratulate G.S. Bhavana. Then next, second prize goes to K. Sanjana, BZC first year from RBVRR Women's College. She has presented a PowerPoint on awareness on plastic pollution. And the third prize in this category goes to Krishnasri from Government Degree College for Women, Begumpet. And she has presented a video presentation on green chemistry. The next, the same third prize is shared by another participant. Her name is Jabili from RBVRR Women's College. She has presented on the title Deforestation and Reforestation. So I congratulate all the winners of video making presentations. Then next I move on to the winners of model making. So the first prize in this category goes to P. Poojitha, P. Bhargavi, P. Archana, Pallavi, Harshita and Anshu from Government Degree College for Women, Begumpet. They have made a model on the topic rainwater harvesting. Then second prize goes to Poojitha and Anisha Anil Kumar from Government Degree College for Women, Begumpet, on the topic sustainable chemistry. The third prize in this category goes to Sara Rehman and Samreen from Government Degree College for Women, Begumpet. They have made a model on the topic integrated farming. So then I also congratulate all the winners of model making. Then next I move on to winners of poster presentations. The first prize in poster presentation category goes to Vadla Pranavi from St. Anne's College. Then second prize goes to P. Sri Renuka Sai from Government Degree College for Women, Begumpet. Then second prize is also shared by one more participant. She is Sana from RBVRR Women's College. And third prize goes to Hemant from Bhavans Vivekananda College. So I once again congratulate all the prize winners and appreciate all the participants who have enthusiastically participated. Now I request the winners of video presentations to present your to give your live presentations on your respective topics. So first I call upon GS Bhavana from Government Degree College, Begumpet, to start with her presentation.
Yes, ma'am, thank you. Is my screen visible?
Yes. Yes, it is visible.
Firstly, I would like to thank all the degree for giving me this opportunity to present. On the account of World Environment Day, today we assemble together to admire our Mother Nature. Our theme for this year is only one earth, which leads to the path of living sustainably in harmony with nature. Just as our birthday celebrates the blessing of life, let this Earth Day be a reminder that the only way we will survive is if our planet Earth thrives. So introducing myself, I, GS Bhavana from Group BSc BTZC, third year from college GDCW Begumpet, came up with the topic entitled Stability with Sustainability. What do you mean by sustainable living? Well, a lifestyle that attempts to reduce an individual's or society's use of the Earth's natural resources is known as sustainable living. We generally call it as Earth Harmony Living or Net Zero Living. On everyday basis, because of our convenient lifestyle, we generally tend to generate a lot of waste in our household itself, which is going to end up just in landfills outside our city. The key lies in making mindful decisions, which might not be that difficult. Is this possible through this way? Why only through sustainable living? Well, when a community practices a sustainable living, the health in environmental quality, maintaining a sustainable lifestyle helps reduce carbon footprint and pollution, which is a key to a healthy community. Little drops of water make a mighty ocean. In the same way, little things we do will make a huge difference in sustainable environment for future. Going with the motto, be the change that you wish to see in others, here are some of my sustainable swabs which we have changed and followed in our daily lifestyle. The primary one is that the dustbin lining we use is newspaper, because the garbage cover we generally use in our daily life are decomposable only when some form of heat is applied to them. Instead of continuing to add up waste out of my house, we started using alternatives, that is newspaper, for dustbin. The vegetable waste which comes out of our kitchen goes to compost bin that helps in preparing compost, which can be used for our plants as a fertilizer. Another daily lifestyle changes, that is, cleaning the milk packet before disposing, giving a horizontal cut, and stop snipping the edges of these small molecules are hard to recycle. These small things are also crucially important to be known in our daily lives. To eliminate the use of plastic in our daily life, we have switched to the eco-friendly bags and replaced our utensils to glass or steel containers, which gives us a perfectly sustainable kitchen. Use of single-use plastic or non-biodegradable takes years to disintegrate. Switching to reusable alternatives helps in saving earth. Minimalism is a great way to help the environment. But as a Gen Z, my clothing options has always been challenging. But as a part of minimal clothing, it is better to have few clothes which are comfortable and eco-friendly rather than having a clutter. Another daily activity, such as closing utensils with lids while cooking, helps in 25% less consumption of energy. Small changes like using LEDs instead of LCDs, switching off light and fans not in use, using eco-friendly transportation like bicycle and hydrogen vehicles leads to zero carbon footprint. Following the sustainable practices with our R mantra, that is, rethink your choices, refuse single use, reduce consumption, reuse everything, refurbish old stuff, repair, repurpose, recycle, helps in harmony. Because a smarter planet is a sustainable planet. An integrated approach where a pillar is eventually shouldering the weight of sustainable development ensures living in harmony with nature. These three pillars include environmental, economic, and social, giving us a sustainable development in the future. Here is an example of a social definitive step towards a sustainable living by the Corner House Ice Cream Parlor located in Bangalore, which has an amazing concept called Bring Your Own Ball. Every such paper ball saved is used by them to help see you pay. Seeing this, people started getting steel boxes for food parcels instead of using plastic covers, which is simple and yet thoughtful towards nature. It is our responsibility to not only protect nature, but create a sustainable world where environment doesn't need protection. With this hope, we achieve stability with sustainability. Thank you.
Thank you, Bhavana. It was an interesting presentation, and I again congratulate you for winning the first prize in this category.
Thank you, Bhavana.
Now, next, I call K. Sanjana from RBVRR Women's College to present her video. Yes, it is visible. Sorry to interrupt you. Please rotate your screen so that the slides will be more clear and visible to us.
Plastic pollution means it is the accumulation of plastic products. That means increase in the content of plastic products in the environment and can adversely affect the wildlife habitat as well as the human life habitat. And these are the causes of plastic pollution. As the plastic is less expensive, it is cheap, it is durable, so all the people tend to buy this plastic item. But they don't know that it is very harmful to the environment. So these are the major contributors to this problem today in Tokyo. The first one is plain old trash. And just now I said that the plastic is cheap and less expensive, so the people will tend to buy this plastic. So when they are decomposing, they don't know that this plastic they don't decompose easily. Because and it also pollutes the land as well as the air. And the second thing is plastic takes 400 years and even more to decompose. So these people will decompose easily. But we don't know that the decomposition rate of plastic typically in the system 500 to 600 years. And there is an agency called Environmental Protection Agency. They say that the every plastic that made and dumped in the environment are still exist. The third thing is fishing. Generally, fishing is an occupation. Of course, it is very necessary for the world because the people need to eat the fish for the survival. So, but we don't know that here the fishing net is made up of plastic. So, during the fishing, what will happen is the fishing net may broke during the fishing. So, the fishing net may remain in the water environment only. So, this tends to the releasing of chemical substances in the water. So, this not only pollutes the air, but also kills the aquatic life. And the fourth thing is disposing of plastic and garbage. Some people will burn this plastic item, but it tends to release the chemical substances that are toxic in nature. These are the effects of plastic pollution. In this first picture, we can observe that when we throw the plastic items on the land, so the birds, they get stuck in the plastic items, or sometimes they swallow the plastic items, and that leads to the death of organisms. And the second picture also same thing, when we throw the plastic items on the land, this animal, they eat this plastic item, because they don't know that the plastic items will go dead. So they ingest this plastic item, so the plastic will go digest and that leads to the death of the organism. In the third and fourth pictures also, when we throw this plastic item in the water, the aquatic organism, they get stuck in this plastic item, or sometimes they may swallow this plastic item and that leads to the death of the organism. And these are the plastic that is going to impact on our human health. This causes the irritation in the eyes, vision failure, breathing difficulties, asthma, respiratory problems, liver dysfunction, skin diseases, headache, dizziness, thyroid, lung problems, diarrhea, etc. This is how the plastic is going to impact on the human health. And this is the safety measures of plastic pollution. Actually, we know this theme that is reduce, recycle, and recover. So, through this theme, at least we can reduce the little amount of plastic pollution. And this is the poster that says no to plastic. That means instead of bags, we should instead of plastic bags, we can use the eco-friendly bags. And we should not throw the plastic items in the water. And we should not throw the plastic items in the land. And we should not use the straws. So these are the some things that they say that say no to the plastic. And this is the young reason they need to use the plastic bag. Because it pollutes the air, it doesn't degrade, it's hard to recycle, it may damage the bottles, it gets wet, alternative, it harms human health to buy and clean it. Thank you, ma'am, for giving this valuable opportunity.
Thank you, Sanjana. Next, I would like to invite Krishna Sri from Government Degree College Women to present on the topic Green Chemistry.
Good afternoon to all dignitaries and my dear friends. Firstly, I would like to thank everyone for giving me this opportunity. Is my screen visible?
Yes, it is visible.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Hello, everyone. I'm Krishna Sri from BSc BTZ final year from GDCW Begumpet. So before getting into the topic, I would like to wish you all a very happy Environmental Day. And the theme for the World Environmental Day 2022 is Only One Earth. In the universe, there are billions of galaxies. In our galaxy, there are billions of planets. But there is only one Earth. And this year, the World Environmental Day is being hosted by Sweden. Moving on, I will be presenting the topic sustainable chemistry, that is green chemistry. So this green chemistry is an excellent concept by which we can gain stability with sustainability. First, let us know what is green chemistry. Many a times we have heard the term green chemistry, but probably we have never stopped and thought about its real meaning. We always tend to associate with the word green chemistry, green, which is something clean, environmental friendly, which can enhance our life, of course. But what exactly is green chemistry and why is it so important for us? IUPAC, that is the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, defines the green chemistry as the invention, design, and application of the chemical products and processes to reduce or to eliminate the use and the generation of the hazardous substances. Green chemistry has gained immense popularity as it applies across the design, manufacture, use, and the ultimate disposal of the chemical products. Paul Anastas and John C. Barnes has demarcated 12 principles of green chemistry in their book Green Chemistry Theory and Practice in the year 1998. So Paul Anastas is regarded as the father of green chemistry. So let us discuss about some principles of green chemistry. So the first principle is about prevention. Prevention is always better than cure. So it is better to prevent the waste than to treat or clean up the waste after it has been created. The second principle tells us about the atom economy. So synthetic methods should be designed in order to maximize the incorporation of all the materials which are used in the process into the final product. So the third principle's perspective is about the less hazardous chemical synthesis. Whenever practicable, synthetic methods should be designed to use and to generate substances that possesses little or no toxicity to human health as well as the environment. The fourth principle is about the design of safer chemicals. The chemical products should be designed to affect their desired function while minimizing their toxicity. So the fifth principle is about the usage of safer solvents and auxiliaries. The use of auxiliary substances like the solvents, separation agents should be made unnecessary whenever possible and innocuous when used. So the sixth principle is about the design for energy efficiency. The energy requirements of chemical processes should be recognized for their environmental and economic impact, and they must be minimized. If possible, synthetic methods should be conducted at ambient temperatures and pressures. The seventh principle talks about the use of renewable feedstock. A raw material or a feedstock should be renewable rather than depleting whenever technically and economically practicable. The eighth principle is about the reduction or avoiding the usage of derivatives. So the unnecessary derivatization like the use of blocking groups, protection or deprotection of temporary modifications of some physical or chemical process should be minimized or avoided if possible, because such steps require additional reagents and they can generate a lot of waste. Then comes catalysis. So the catalytic reagents are superior to the stoichiometric reagents. Like the catalysis is a process of increasing the rate of chemical reaction, right? So by adding these substances called catalysts, the rate of reaction will speed up. And this process can be used repeatedly, so the catalytic reagent generate lesser waste than the stoichiometric reagent. Then the tenth principle is about the design for degradation. The chemical products should be designed so that at the end of their function, they must break down into innocuous degradation products and they should not persist in the environment for a longer period of time. The 11th principle is about the real-time analysis for the pollution prevention. The analytical methodologies need to be further developed to allow for real-time in-processing monitoring and control prior to the formation of the hazardous substances. The 12th principle is about inherently safer chemical usage for the accident prevention. Substances and some forms of substances which are used in the chemical process should be chosen such that they have to minimize the potential for chemical accidents, including the releases, explosions, and the fires. Since 1990s, many steps have been forwarded which have made by the scientists and the social community, and we are now fully aware that the greener process and products will lead to a more sustainable life and a cleaner earth. But this is not enough so far. Today, more than 98% of the organic chemicals are still derived from the petroleum and other harmful chemicals. As students, we have to try to go deeply into the green chemistry, see beyond our experiments and process, and take our research out of the lab. Only by doing this, we will be able to build a more sustainable world. Concluding with, green chemistry is scientifically sound, cost-effective, and most importantly, it leads us towards a sustainable civilization. Thank you.
Thank you, Krishna Sri. Then next, I would like to invite Jabili from RBVRR Women's College to share her views on deforestation and reforestation.
Hi everyone. Good afternoon, ma'am. And myself. Hello. Ma'am, can you see my PPT, ma'am?
Yes, it is visible and you are audible. You can continue.
I've chosen the topic.
Jabili, sorry to interrupt you. Please rotate your screen.
Good. Ma'am. I've chosen the topic about deforestation and reforestation. Let this PPT explain what is deforestation and reforestation. So in this picture we can see that there is a greenery, there is a lot of greenness that is known as the reforestation. And deforestation is nothing but the cutting of trees and dryness of the land. And human causes of global changes, mainly the main cause of global changes in our country, that is mainly of deforestation and reforestation. So from this picture, we can say that deforestation is nothing but cutting of the plants and cleaning the land for the personal purpose like buildings, etc. So reforestation is nothing but planting the trees and making the greenery on the land. And mainly coming to deforestation, what is deforestation? So deforestation is the removal of forested or stand of trees where the land is then converted into non-forest use. For example, where the land that is useful for agriculture or for any other purpose, that land that makes into non-useful for the crop growing of crops and etc. So example is conversion of forest land into farms or urban villages. So effects of deforestation, there are many effects of deforestation. Some are the area, droughts, wildfires, increasing in temperature, animals that vegetation and resources loss. So, for example, there is an animal that is under the tree, which is taking shelter. So whenever we are cutting the trees or burning the plants or what, etc. So the animals may shift to other plant and it goes to the other shelter. That may repeat on the same plant. So the animal may die after some days or some months. So that is of animal death. And there is so many cases of deforestation, mainly deforestation in effect of agriculture, logging, mining and dams, mainly on agriculture. So what the effect that deforestation shows on agriculture? Leading cause of deforestation. Farmers need land to grow crops and raise animals. They remove forest land to make room for farms. They use slash and burn to perform deforestation. Slash and burn is cutting away and burning the forests. mainly agriculture, that what the farmers do on agriculture, this they probably they will probably plant and they will give the food for us. If we do deforestation on land or we burn the plants, so we can't take the food. Farmers can't grow the crops, then we can't take the food. So we should not do deforestation. And if we do deforestation, then there will be less of agriculture in our country. So what is logging? Loggers get tall trees for their woods. Logging is illegal in many areas like national parks. Many of them cut the trees and they will sell the wood for their personal purposes like. We know that wood is very useful for paper production and building materials, but it is a legal thing, so we should not do it as a personal thing. It's very dangerous for us. And mining, mineral search for materials like gold, copper, and aluminium. This clears the land, including the forest that occupies it. It contaminates the ecosystem with runoff. We know the minerals like materials like gold, copper, and aluminium are other minerals. So that which will come from the mining. So what is a dam? Dams will generate the hydroelectrical energy. Flood forests that are upstream. Trees decay slowly when dams are built in tropical waters. And the water of oxygen. We know that hydroelectrical energy, we have learned in chemistry. So what is about it? Which will generate the hydroelectric chemistry? So this is about deforestation. So coming to deforestation is nothing but this is the process of re-establishing the plants and planting the greenery or planting the plants. That is about deforestation. So what is the importance of reforestation? The it is gradually losing the biodiversity as more and more animals are focused on their natural habitat. The only way to check this adverse effect is deforestation. We need to plant the plants. Whatever, if we want to plant it with daily, monthly, at least on an occasion, at least we need to plant a tree which will give us the protection and which will give us the shelter and which gives us the food without any income. This it takes somewhat land for the grow. And what are the advantages of reforestation? So which will reduce the carbon dioxide in it, and its reproduction will increase the number of plants that more carbon dioxide gets absorbed by those plants, and the air quality increases. So mainly I want to say advantages of reforestation is, if we cut out the plants, there won't be oxygen for us. It will be a problem to us, not only for the plants we cut, it will be dangerous to us also. So we need to plant a tree at least monthly once, at least on an occasion. So it won't give us loss anything. It gives us food, it gives us shelter and everything. So thank you so much for giving me such a great opportunity. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Jabili. Next, I would like to share the posters of the students who have won prizes in this poster making category. This is the poster of Vadla Pranavi, who has won the first prize in this category.
Thank you, ma'am.
The next I move on to Yes, Pranavi, if you like to share your views or anything on this particular celebrations, you can speak.
Yes. So the only thing we have to do is to take care of it, and we shouldn't be a bother for other species. Let's really let other species live happy environment day. Thank you, ma'am.
Next, this is the poster which was presented by P. Sri Renuka Sai from Government Degree College for Women, Begumpet. She has won the second prize. Next, I would like to present the second winner of the same category, Sana from RBVRR Women's College. Just give me a minute. Yes, this is the poster which was made by Sana. And she also won the second prize. Next, I would like to present the poster of the third winner of this category. This is the poster which was made by Hemant from Bhavans Vivekananda College. Yes, the winners of the poster making competitions were there. Like if you want to give any feedback or if you want to share your opinions, you are invited to share. Okay, next I would like to share the certificates of the prize winners in all competitions. Congratulates Pranavi for securing the first prize in e-poster presentation.
Thank you.
Next, I congratulate Renuka Sai from GDCW for securing the second prize.
Thank you, ma'am.
Next, I would like to congratulate Sana Begum from RBVRR Women's College for securing the second prize in e-poster presentation competitions. Next, I congratulate Hemant from Bhavans Vivekananda College for securing the third prize in e-poster competitions on the topic global warming. Next, I would like to share the certificates of winners of model making. Yes, there were a group of participants who have secured the first prize on the topic rainwater harvesting. They were Pujita, P. Bhargavi, Archana, Pallavi, Harshita and Anshu from GDCW. And one more thing I would like to share is all the winners of model making presentations are from Government Degree College, Begumpet. I appreciate and congratulate all the winners. And I also appreciate and congratulate the faculty members who are who actively encouraged and motivated the students to make such a beautiful and excellent presentations. This is the certificate of Archana, who has secured her first prize in the same topic. Then next is Harshita. Then next I move on to the same second prize in model making category was shared by two people. One is Pujita from Government Degree College. They have made a model on the topic sustainable chemistry. Congratulations, Pujita. Then next third prize winners are Samreen and Sara for making a model on integrated farming. So next we move on to the winners of video making presentations. Here first prize goes to Bhavana. Congratulations, Bhavana.
Thank you.
Then second prize goes to K. Sanjana from RBVRR College. Congratulations, Sanjana.
Thank you.
Third prize is shared by two girls, Krishna Sri from Government Degree College for Women and Jabili from RBVRR Women's College.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. So I once again congratulate everybody and also appreciate all the participants. And now I would like to hand over the session to Pranita ma'am from Government Degree Women's College.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, this is Dr. G. Pranita. Assistant Professor of Chemistry, Government Degree College Department, Begumpet. Today we have gathered here to commemorate World Environment Day with the theme of Only One Year. As part of this, we, Department of Chemistry, GDCW Begumpet, and the Department of Chemistry, RBVRR Women's College organized intercollegiate competition. So we got very good response of this program. Many from the many colleges, we got the response. Even last year also we have conducted, we had a very good response for this program. So same program we have continued in this year also to encourage the students to know about the environment issues. The main motto of conducting this program as part of the globalization, nowadays we are ignoring the saving of our mother earth. At least by conducting such a program, we can come to know what are the minimum steps we can do at our level to save our mother earth. So I congratulate all the prize winners and participants. And I thank to Dr. V. Jeevanjyoti ma'am, HOD and of the Department of RBVRR Women's College for your support and collaborating with us, ma'am. And my extended thanks to faculty coordinators of Ms. P. Sujana and Dr. B. Priyanka of RBVRR Women's College, Dr. Sunita and Ms. M. Prabhavati of GDCW Begumpet for their technical support. And my heartfelt thanks to both the college principals, Dr. J. Archita Devi, principal, RBVRR Women's College, and Dr. K. Padmavati, principal, GDCW Begumpet, who constantly encourage us to conduct such programs. Once again, I congratulate all the prize winners and appreciation from both the departments to all the participants. Let us follow the slogan like reduce, reuse, recycle. I request all of you not only presenting and doing such activities, I hope everyone implement whatever you have learned by this program, whatever the steps you have to do to save our mother. I hope everyone follow. With this, I conclude this. Once again, thank you, Manu.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
All the participants will receive e-certificates. Those who registered and submitted your PPT posters will be given the e-certificates. So it will be sent to your mail IDs. Thank you. Thank you all. And thank you, Pranita, for your support and guidance to all the faculty members who are organizing this. So we will not stop. We will be doing the other activities also. So this is our routine activity which we have done previously and also this year. But we will plan one faculty development, faculty exchange program with PG students. Okay, Pranita, thank you.
Same kind of encouragement and everything we will expect from the next program.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much, for your collaborations and making this inter-college competitions a great success. Yes, ma'am. Yes, I thank all the participants.
Yeah, we can.
For attending the session and participating. Thank you all.
Thank you.